This is my first headphone review, and I'm going to tell you right off the bat, I'm not a headphone guy. I have many headphones here. I have more headphones on the way, but I'm not a headphone guy. I'm a speaker guy. I like to sit down in a room, big room, small room, and annoy the hell out of everyone around me with speakers. So, if it was a perfect world, I'd be able to do that everywhere. I'd be able to go on a bus and sit in the back of an auditorium, and I just have giant speakers I rolled around with me. But I can't, so I have to resort to headphones. And I've had a couple headphones over the last decade. Some of them are good, some of them sucked, but they were all headphones, I can guarantee you that much. Now, I've done the Monoprice Ear IEM review, and those astonished me, so I did a review of them. And then I had to buy my brother a gift, so I'm like, he needs some new headphones. These were his headphones. Sennheiser HD202s, probably 8 years old. These were my headphones of choice when I built my computer back in like 04. These are the Sennheiser HD280 Pros. Sennheiser 280 Pros. These are the 202s. And I used these for 9 years. And only recently have they started breaking, like physically breaking. Original wire, I changed the pads once, 2 years ago, a year ago, whatever. They worked, but now when they started developing a tear, low end would actually rattle the right channel, just gently. And with the breaking, I said, okay, it's time to buy new headphones. So the first one I went out and bought, I have a friend, The Yield, who's a headphone nut. He is the person who probably should be reviewing headphones. Although I think you're going to get a better perspective from a man that likes speakers. And he recommended I get the Budget Kings, which are these Koss ProDJ100s. And you can't just buy these on their own, because these pads, frankly, are very thin and they're very uncomfortable. And they're too small. So what you do is you buy the replacement pads for Audio-Technica M50s, which are the high-rated $150 headphones that everyone's like, these are the ones you buy. You buy the M50s. So these headphones, when I got them, were $60 or $65. And the pads I bought used from him, because he had an extra pair, because I don't know how many pairs he's actually got. But I got them for $25. They're about $25 new. So for $65 plus $25, I got a set of headphones. And they were good. They're better than my 280 Pros were. These are still the best headphones you can get if you just need to have the world go away. Because, I mean, a bullet point in them is 32 dB attenuation, which means you put them on, and then you can fire your rifle at the shooting range. Although, probably wouldn't recommend that, really. But yeah, these are the best for shutting things off. They have been, when the pads break down, they sort of lose that little feature. But when you put these on with the pads, they're way more comfortable. They're way thicker, the pads. And they're way taller. And guess what? These Koss ProDJs have dropped to like $40. So for $40 plus $25, for $65, you got a set of these. And these have better bass response than most things I've heard. The only headphones that I don't have here that are my brother's girlfriend's headphones that I sort of borrowed are the Super Lux. I forget the model number, but those will be coming here to get a review. Those have insane bass. These have very good bass. And there's a couple things I need to talk to you about. Yes, these pads are uncomfortable, but this lining here is just a lining. It's just a piece of fabric. When you switch to the M50 pads, this is no longer a lining. There's about an eighth inch thick, you can't see it, but I could feel it. There's an eighth inch thick foam underneath this. And what that does is sort of kills the highs a bit. So bigger pads, better seal, better bass than the stock pads, but that back seal there is just, it murders the highs. And I found when I put them on, I had to tweak EQs to not go crazy. So just be aware of that. You can cut a hole in this, just, you know, get a dime and trace a dime, or just cut a slit or an X or a triangle, whatever you want to cut, and let some of those highs out. And I'd probably recommend that. If you put them on, you think they sounded not muddy. Muddy is not the right word. Sort of extra warm, I guess is the word. And being me, I got to do something crazy. So behold the headphone recording box. And this is never done because it's probably stupid and will be frowned upon or looked down on. But you know what? I'm going to mix this in right now, and you're going to hear that when I talk into this, you get a pretty good binaural image. It's set up now, so this is left, this is right, and I've got my Pioneer VSX D1S powering, which ones are these? These are these stock Koss ProDJ100s with these stock pads, and you're going to hear a difference through this. I've made sure of it. I'm going to actually monitor these through those on this. And the thing you should know is I'm capable of getting that volume to peak this at a particular part in a train demo. I'm not sure if I'd probably switch back to my regular microphone now. I'm thinking into the future. Close that. So how are we there? Yes. All right, I'm just going to make sure these are leveled properly, looking at the peak meter. Yep. Two distinct beats. These are ready to go. Is there a benefit to demoing headphones like this for you? Like, you could tell if they're any good. Well, I record speakers all the time and people seem to like that. So let's record some headphones. And when you compare on YouTube, as long as I have the volumes matched and I use the same setups of songs, I'll see if any of these get pulled off of the YouTube and adjust my list, then you should be able to directly compare on YouTube, through whatever you've got, headphones and their slight characteristic changes. These should have, when I switch headphones out, you should note that these have better highs and slightly less bass than these. Also, I'll talk about the build of them in a minute. Let's get some tones going. This is the lowest song I have. I don't know where I'm mixing that to. I'm gonna yell into the box. And this is actually a good test if I just keep talking. If you. They're very good. They're very good through this to my headphones, which are the same headphones. Just a little, I'll pull them off. Make sure they're working left and right, which have to be reversed for me to hear them right, which is interesting. None of these get pulled. Hello, box. Hello.
sound pretty good. Can you sound pretty good?
We get blocked. I don't know which songs to take out of this list. Pause for a minute. Edit back over. I think it's important now, at some point, that I switch to these, which I'm actually recommending, with the added extra pads, and we do a comparison, so I'll put those on when they're playing. Because it sounds cooler to you guys. One. Okay, now I'll switch these. Will be my monitoring pair. And it's going to be a very rare occasion where I have two identical headphones where I could do this, which was important so that I could listen and say, okay, A sounds like A, so A must be correct. Let's go. We'll put... Actually, I've got to do the train effect first. So, excuse me for a second. It actually has to go up. It goes to the pads. Alright. It had to be raised, the bigger pads further away, that eighth inch of foam I talked about, which means it actually quiets them down a bit compared to the stock pads. Which I can lower my output to my head. Let's run through a few of these. so much less comfortable. These are so much less comfortable than those. But the high reproduction's better on these, and I like highs, and those are a little bit bassy. So, a little modification to that. Definitely can't keep these pads. They're just like, they feel like $40 pads, even though the headphones are made of machined aluminum, by the way. They just hurt to wear if you have big ears.
Going on, high nose, eyes closed. and I don't want another day to break. Take off, steal off, night away.
Okay, pause the music. I'll leave this running if you'd like me to talk into this. This is interesting. They're really good. I would absolutely recommend nothing else for someone with under a $75 budget. I mean, right now, you're looking at $65, $40 for the headphones and $40 for the pads. Can you live without the pads? Here are the original pads. Here's the bag for the M50s and the ones I'm wearing, which I should take off now. You can live without the pads if you have tiny ears, because these are on ear and these are over ear. I mean, they don't look it. Way more comfortable pads. Way thicker. They kill the highs a little bit too much, so I would recommend modding that. You could play around. As far as the actual headphones go, my friend sat on them and broke them. My friend, the Yield, who is the headphone guy, sat on his pair, pulled the pads off, threw them in the garbage, because they were $40. And I said, you're an idiot. I would have taken it for spare parts, because they're very, very good. For what they cost, it's why they're the budget kings. Go to Headphone and look them up. They are really, 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 really good. The mono switch in the bottom, don't really see a use for that. If you're DJing and you're only doing this, and you only have one in your... That's why this turns around like this, by the way, with such articulation. I mean, this... It has enough articulation to pretty much sit in any configuration you'd like. So it's got a mono switch. The cord is really nice. Like, my Sennheiser cord, obviously I can't judge against it because it's 9 years old and it's been through hell. But this is a super... This is like the nicest stretch cord because it actually goes to closed. It doesn't just leave itself open. The construction is good. The cups are made of aluminum, I think. Unless it's really good fake. Maybe it is plastic. I don't know. You know what? Might be plastic. So I'm going to tell. I have to damage these. I'm going to damage these for you guys. Here's a razor blade. Nope, they're aluminum. I just exposed silver. So I wasn't sure, because I'm like, how does a $40 pair of headphones have machined aluminum actual cups? And because they're awesome, that's why. Because Koss makes really good headphones. So, aluminum cups. This bit here is plastic, probably metal reinforced. I'd have to rip it apart to find out. It's got screws in it, so maybe it's just a plastic web. Goes up into a plastic thing. Then you've got these machined aluminum... These do unscrew. I don't know why they unscrew. I guess if you need to take it apart. But the actual little cups on the end are functional. They support the whole thing. They say Koss on them. The headband is pretty standard stuff. This is actually decent feeling up here. Rubberized. It's got a felt thing over here that's going to collect all your hair. All your pet hair and your hair falling off your head. It's all going to get stuck there. They get super wide. Super wide. So they'll fit pretty much anyone's head. Just concern yourself with the ear cups, which I am going to... Hopefully they stay in stock on Amazon, because they went out of stock for a while. And I don't want to buy them from anywhere else. They're a little more expensive. So, there you go. The wire is solid. You can't replace it. It's $40. I bought this pair because it's $40. When the price went from $65 to $40... Okay, I need an extra pair of those, leave in a junk drawer. Of course, when it goes down, they're $40, and they're really good. So yeah, anyone that ever says, oh, M50s are comfortable, well, here are the pads from them. So whatever they say applies to this. The band can't really do much to affect how it is unless it squeezes down or it's got spikes sticking out the top. And you've heard them, and you can go back and do a YouTube jump back and forth and see what sound differences are. You definitely can hear. These are, in the classic sense, warmer, where it's more bass-focused, a little bit less retardo highs. I don't find the highs in these retarded. I don't find them harsh. They're there, and they're in your face a bit, because, it's again, the pads are smaller, so it's closer to your head. So I had to raise the volume when I switched to these. So be mindful. Get these. Play with them for a week. Listen to them. Then buy the pads. Swap the pads. It's easy enough to swap the pads. You just peel this off. The other pads slide on over. Way easier than it was to replace the pads of my Sennheisers. And evaluate for yourself. You can't trust me. What the hell am I? Are you listening to this on YouTube? You listen to a crazy person on YouTube. Phone. Go away, phone. Yeah. But, yeah. That's my first headphone review. I hope you enjoyed it. I did. Go away, phone. Go a phone away. Yay. All right. So I'm going to put these away now, and then I'm going to get to my headphones. We'll see how those are doing.